Hello friends, welcome to Awdhesh Academy. Friends, today we are going to discuss the first question of UPSC General Studies Paper 4, that is Ethics, Integrity and Aptitude 2022. And this question was pertaining to the travesty of justice for effective service delivery and good governance. So friends, let us first read the question. The question was as follows. Wisdom lies in knowing what to reckon with and what to overlook. An officer being engrossed with the periphery, ignoring the core issues before him, is not rare in the bureaucracy. Do you agree that such preoccupation of an administrator leads to travesty of justice to the cause of effective service delivery and good governance? Critically evaluate. And the answer has to be written in 150 words. So friends, first of all, we have to understand the question itself. The question is about providing effective service delivery and good governance. Now what happens that many officers are actually spending a lot of time on dealing with the superficial issues instead of focusing on the core or important issues. As a result, a lot of their time gets wasted and they are not able to do justice with their job. Now, when we talk about the travesty of justice, it basically means you are making a mockery of justice. That means you are showing that you are doing justice because maybe you are producing the statistics, but ultimately the justice is not done. You are not doing justice to your job. So friends, let's understand this question and then we will answer this particular question. So let's proceed with the answer of the question. Now we must know that the civil servant's role is not only to implement the law. They are also making the law when they are in the ministries, and they must ensure that whatever purpose the law is made, that should be achieved by implementation of the law. So remember that civil servant must not only understand the letter of the law, but also the spirit of the law. The spirit of the law is required because we must see that when the law is implemented, the purpose is achieved. So the focus of the bureaucrat must be to fulfill the goal of law and policy. For example, if you talk about police department, now police department's job is to maintain the law and order and reduce crime. So their energy should be spent in such a manner that the crime is reduced or minimized and law and order is maintained. In the same way, if you talk about the tax officer, they must try to maximize the taxes. So whatever job you do, you must see that the goal is achieved. Remember that civil servants have multiple responsibilities and functions, and they can spend their energy on such peripheral issue, or they can spend their energy on the core issue and therefore achieve the goal of the organization. So they must focus on discharging functions that can maximize the benefit to the people. Now, for example, let's talk about some of the examples like tax officer. Now, tax officer's job is to collect the taxes. Now, generally it is seen that in most of the countries, 90% of the taxes will come from 10% of the people, and 10% of the taxes will come from 90% of the people. So if you are focusing on the major taxpayer and making the major cases, you can maximize the collection of the taxes. But if your energy is spent on the small taxpayers, in that case the effort is same because the investigation and the carrying out all the searches and all that will take same place, same time, but the result will be less. Therefore, the tax officer must focus on the big taxpayers and evaders. Similarly, the police officers also must focus on the heinous crime, gangsters and notorious criminal, and ignore the petty crimes, because there are so many petty crimes taking place which are not affecting the society much. But if you focus on the major crime, eliminate the gangsters, then the petty crime will also come into control and the maximum benefit will go to the public and to the government and to the society. So remember that when we focus on the important and priority issues, we maximize the benefit to the society. So remember that good governance is important and that is why we are there in the job. And so how the good governance is achieved? So first of all, let's see what is the meaning of good governance. When the government performs its function efficiently, that means with minimum resources, we are providing maximum benefit. That is what is the meaning of efficiency. Effectively, that means we are achieving the goal. And for the good of the citizen, that means public interest. So these things we have to see that a good civil servant must achieve that. Now the civil servants or the good administrator has a limited resources of the government, and they must focus on the core issues, and that way they can work most effectively, because they will decide their priority right and focus on the most important public issues, and therefore yield the maximum result. So, and if we don't do that, what happens? That it's a travesty of justice. When the administrators are preoccupied on the petty and superficial matters, they can't provide effective service delivery and good governance, because most of their energy are spent on doing less important work, less result is produced. So they may be doing a lot of work, but they are not able to do justice with their job. And therefore, a civil servant must focus on the important matters and overlook the superficial and small matters. So that is how we can explain, write the answer of this question, that civil servant must focus on the core issues, the important issues, and that is how they will be able to do the justice with their job. So write the answer in your words. Thank you very much.